New Balance 550 Lunar New Year. Now, I have to confess, I've never been a big New Balance guy. A lot of my sneakerhead experience is trying to recapture moments of my childhood, trying to capture those nostalgic memories. And as someone growing up in the 90s, that's obviously dominated by Nike, Jordan, even Reebok, specifically because of Allen Iverson. And New Balance was just not a big thing, at least not where I grew up. Obviously, New Balance has been doing great the last few years. Their popularity has surged. And I've definitely kept an eye on them, and I have been following their progress. So on December 30th, when they released their Lunar New Year collection, I did pick up a pair of these New Balance Lunar New Year 550 Driftwood. The New Balance Lunar New Year collection included other shoes such as the 550 Sea Salt and Timberwolf, and the 2002 R Zinc, and this Driftwood color was definitely my favorite one. Or at least I thought it was my favorite one, but I'll get to that later. Now, I picked these up for $130 on newbalance.com. I sat on their online queue for 45 minutes, and I'm not really sure why, because as of this time of recording, and it's actually Lunar New Year day right now, most sizes are still available on newbalance.com. Now, the 550 is my favorite silhouette out of all New Balance shoes. I was torn between the Driftwood and the Sea Salt and Timberwolf, but I thought the Sea Salt and Timberwolf is pretty much another white sneaker, and I've just got so many other white sneakers that I probably would wear over them. And the Driftwood seemed a bit more unique, so I went with those. The official colors listed for this shoe are Driftwood, Turtle Dove, and Concrete. Now, I gotta give New Balance credit to actually releasing these shoes well ahead of Lunar New Year, so people can actually wear them on Lunar New Year, unlike some other companies. I'm looking at you, Nike. So the Turtle Dove color refers to the midsole, the sock liner, the laces, as well as the very recognizable N. And the color Concrete appears on the sole of the shoe, as well as right above the midsole. One cool little detail is all the patterns around the midsole. I like when companies add these little details to a shoe that you don't necessarily pick up in photos. Hints of deep red is also present on this shoe. Most noticeably is the New Balance logo on the booty of the shoe, as well as the words New Balance on the tongue of the shoe. The shoe comes with an extra set of laces and that deep red colorway. In person, this deep red is about as dark as red can go. And obviously the upper sole, 90% of the shoe is the color Driftwood. This shoe is made out of pretty much all leather, with a little hint of suede just under the sock liner in that concrete color. So they do have a reputation of perhaps having better quality material, better quality leather on their shoes, and I gotta say, that reputation is pretty well deserved. This leather feels pretty soft but durable, and you can see it's tumbled leather, and I know a lot of people prefer that tumbled leather look. One very nitpicky thing I do have about the shoe, specifically on my pair, is the QC, but there is a bit of glue residue just along the midsole over here. Now, obviously that is a very nitpicky thing. It's pretty much impossible to get a 100% flawless shoe nowadays. I'm gonna give them a pass because the rest of the shoe is very well made. Three things I love about this shoe. Now, the 550 silhouette is inspired by 80s classic basketball design. And what I love is that basketball on the tongue of the shoe. Now, as someone that played basketball for most of their life and a huge fan of basketball, I really like that touch. Number two is the Turtle Dove color. Now, it's pretty much a sail color. It kind of gives off that pre-aged vibe. And side note, the Air Jordan 5 DJ Khaled sail colorway, I still am dying to get my hands on them. Now, I think in combination with the Concrete and the Driftwood, it really works. And I'm generally a big fan of sail. Now, the third thing I love about this shoe is the Concrete color. It's pretty much just gray, but I guess Concrete helps differentiate the shoe again. And gray is obviously a very versatile and wearable color. I kind of do wonder what the shoe would look like if the Driftwood and the Concrete would switch color blocking. I think that'll look pretty nice. It's kind of ironic that the two things I love about this shoe are two colors that isn't the main color of the shoe. And that brings me to three things that I don't love about this shoe. For some reason, this Driftwood color on my computer screen looked a bit lighter. It almost looked like a shade of tan, and I think I would have preferred that. In person, this Driftwood looks almost pink purplish. It's hard to explain, but it's a shade darker than what I expected. Now, I'm not saying I don't love this shoe overall. I still think it's a very nice shoe, but I think in comparison to the Sea Salt and Timberwolf, looking back at it, I think I would have preferred the Sea Salt. The second thing I don't love about this shoe is my biggest gripe about this shoe. This is part of the Lunar New Year collection, but there's really nothing about this shoe that makes it seem like it's part of the Lunar New Year. I keep looking for a rabbit on this shoe. There's no reference to the year of the rabbit. Now, I think the deep red is probably the reference to Lunar New Year, but honestly, it just seems like a darker red than the usual New Balance logo, so it doesn't really stand out in that way. In fact, judging from photos, none of the shoes that New Balance dropped as part of this capsule is immediately obvious for the Year of the Rabbit. Now compare that to some of the Nike shoes, the Nike Dunk Lows, the Air Jordan 1 Lows. There are parts about those shoes that are just better storytelling. You know that it's part of the Year of the Rabbit. Even if they just replace the New Balance on the heel of the shoe with a rabbit, just a silhouette of the rabbit in that deep red color, that would have done the trick. I'm just a bit confused how any of this ties in to Lunar New Year, but it just seems a little lazy on their end. Now the third thing I don't love about this shoe, and this is very nitpicky, is even though I like the basketball on the tongue, I'm not sure why both the basketballs skew towards the right of the tongue. In my mind, it would have made more sense, provided more balance and symmetry, if the right ball on the right shoe skewed toward the right, and the left ball on the left shoe skewed toward the left. Now maybe my idea sounds better in my head than if it was actually in practice. I'm not a designer, so I could be totally wrong, but at least in my head, if I imagine the ball going opposite directions for each tongue, it probably would have looked better. Now I'm usually a size 9.5 true to size, but I do have wide feet, so I did go up half a size to be safe. Now if you do have wide feet, especially where your toes start, like the knuckles of the feet, if that part is very wide for you, the toe box of the shoe is pretty snug. So if you have very wide feet, I recommend going up half a size. If you have normal, narrow feet, I think you're totally fine going true to size. Now I'm gonna get this on feet, show you what it looks like on my wide stomper feet. Overall, I like this shoe. I just feel like it's missing a little something to differentiate it from other 550s. This does seem like a general release. If you didn't know it was part of the Lunar New Year capsule, I really doubt anyone would be able to pick that up. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think of the New Balance 550 Lunar New Year Driftwood. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And remember, wear your shoes.